Here's one. Swam under there. Let it clear out a little bit. There's also a crayfish. Pretty cool.
You have to look under the rocks to really gauge the health of this place. Peer around the granite boulders and into the moss-covered nooks and crannies. Water is the lifeblood of this place, and as you poke through the leaves and scrounge around in the cool water in the mud, you'll be surprised at what you find. Watch closely, it's pretty quick.
And what kind is that?
This is a seal salamander.
It turns out tiny salamanders, like this seal salamander, are vital to the health of the forest ecosystem.
I think it's important to know what species are here because some species are endemic to this area, and so it's important to know what's here and if that changes over time and why.
Time stands rather still in this old-growth forest of a few surviving hemlock trees, as well as chestnut oaks and hickory. This is the Kelsey Trail Preserve. The 17-acre track is just outside Highlands in Macon County. It's owned by the Highland Cashiers Land Trust.
More salamanders in these woods than any other vertebrate by mass.
This is a black-bellied salamander, Desmognathus quadrimaculatus. It's a stream-dwelling salamander. You can get an idea of that because it's got a keeled tail. So it can use kind of as a paddle. You find it in streams and seeps around here quite a bit.
Researchers are scouring the forest floor looking for salamanders because the slippery creature helps keep this pristine forest in balance. Salamanders are voracious eaters. An adult salamander eats its weight in insects every 2 days. Remove the salamander from the ecosystem and the insect population would explode, increasing the number of insect pests and the potential for insect-borne disease and destruction. Lose the salamander and the system changes.
You can take all the big mammals in an area of forest and take all the salamanders, put it on the scale. Salamanders far outweigh the mammals. This is both a biodiversity hotspot for the number of species, salamanders being one of the more well-known groups, and as well as kind of the density of species. I mean, we look at this forest around here, I mean, it's loaded with vegetation. I mean, this is a temperate rainforest.
As part of the Southern Appalachians, the Kelsey Trail Preserve protects some of the oldest mountains and mountain habitats in the world. The region is a mix of mountains, sedimentary ridges, limestone valleys and coves, and broad basins. It is the perfect mix of habitats for salamanders to survive and thrive.
Here we go.
Did you find something? Koi or a seal? I think it's a seal. No.
Salamanders must live in a moist environment. That's because they breathe through their skin. That permeable skin makes salamanders extremely sensitive to changes in the environment. So scientists consider salamanders a kind of early warning system for water pollution and other ecological problems. Habitat loss, disease, water pollution all affect salamanders first. So keeping a count of the salamander population in an area over time will indicate if the population is falling and the land is in trouble.
Do it again, see if anything's changed, and then if it has, like why, what can we do to prevent this?
What makes this area so special, from the mountain streams below to the granite outcrop here, is that it is simply so old, 250 million years old, and there are species found here that aren't found anywhere else.
This is a special place. It's a relatively high elevation, about 4,000 feet, and there are lots of species that you find further north. So, and this is their the southern extent of their ranges. In addition, there are lots of species that you find further south, and this is the northern extent of their ranges. So it's like north meets south here on the Highlands Plateau.
And so far, with researchers finding several salamanders almost everywhere they look, it appears the salamander population and their forest home is doing fine.
Well, that's one of the things that's really neat is there's so many of them around here. The forest around here,
where we're standing, is we're probably standing in this little area over hundreds of salamanders. I mean, the densities in these forests, 2 to 8 per square meter, just in the forest areas,